All of my tomato plants are beautiful and green and producing, but my tomatoes are not really red. They have streaks of yellow and some have bruises or something. I had the pH tested and it was normal. Is there any way to correct this? Thanks for any help that you can provide. And this is Jenna from Arlington, Tennessee. Mm. Well, I guess we have an example of the question.
Yep, so we got a good one here.
Yeah, it's real good.
This is an example of the bullseye spots that come on tomatoes when they've got anthracnose.
Yeah.
So that's the problem that you're going to get. I mean, he's not alone.
Yeah.
I mean, I have it on my tomatoes, and I've sprayed with the fungicides and things, and you're just not going to get rid of something like that when it first starts. And you got wet weather.
Yeah.
You know, we got rain, I think, forecasted off and on for a while. So, and the blotching, that's a problem, you know, where they don't ripen. You get this yellow kind of blotching through here, and that is high humidity, high temperatures. And I also read that if he's got lush plants, they're real green and a lot of canopy on them, and if he's caged them and they're upright, it may be these are just not getting the sun they need to yellow, to red on up. And if he did, I read what he said about the pH.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking, well, did he actually get a soil test to know if it's got the N, the P, and the K? Because something I read said that lack of potassium can cause irregular ripening. And I also read, and I didn't know this, that there are varieties that are less prone to doing this.
Okay.
But I don't know if I've ever read that on a label. Have you?
I have not.
So I don't know how you would find those cultivars that are less prone to the blotching and the yellow shoulders. Yeah. You know, mine have a lot of the yellow shoulders, where it just gets that old hard core.
Yeah, I know exactly.
And that's more or less the same thing going on. High temps, high humidity, you know.
The old environmental stresses, which you can't
can't do anything about that.
Right. But I would definitely mulch, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Mulching
yeah.
would definitely, you know, help. Maybe a little crop rotation.
Yeah.
Because, you know, this fungus will build up. You know,
that's true. Well, the anthracnose, for sure.
It definitely will build up in the soil.
Yeah.
And then.
Hope for a good year.
Hope for a good year.
Hope for a good weather year.
Wow.
Because we've had some extreme weather. So it's showing up in our vegetable gardens, in our landscapes, obviously.
Right.
You know,
it definitely has. Would you still eat this tomato?
Yeah.
I'll just cut it out.
Shoot, yeah. I'd just cut that bad place out. You know, birds peck mine. I just cut the bird pecks out and keep going.
I keep going. Yeah, I would definitely
eat it. Shoot, I love tomatoes. I'm not going to let the little critters get them.
I just cut that out. It's not going to be a problem.
Yeah, it's all right. And then it might red up a little bit.
It might.
You know, in the house or on the porch.
It might.
You know, put it in there with a banana or an apple or something.
Yeah,
put that ethylene on.
Yeah, let it go and ripen on up. this is a perfect example of concentric greens.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good tomato, you know.
Right, with the yellow streaks, so.
Yeah, that's not uncommon.
Yeah, it's not uncommon.
Not this year, anyway.
We hope you enjoyed the video. We have hundreds more. To subscribe, just click below.